In 2008, our son Sam was tragically killed in a one-punch incident.
17-year-old Sam Davis was punched as he tried to stop a fight at a party on Saturday night.
Just hours after the Panthers' victory, the 17-year-old attended a party at Brighton, where he was beaten after stepping in to break up a fight. Sam was rushed to the Flinders Medical Centre with head injuries, but passed away overnight.
We started the Sammy D Foundation so another family doesn't have to go through what we've been through.
I first heard about the Sammy D Foundation as I had a house, as I was exploring options for our kids to be exposed to during our pastoral care time.
The goal of our presentation is to let people know the consequences of violence, let people know it's a true story, this is what really happened to us. We show lots of pictures of Sam. We show raw emotions. We're standing up and saying this did happen to us.
Well, when I observe the kids, I see direct attention. I see their focus, and the message that he's bringing to the pastoral care time is one in which it just captures the kids' attention. And you can hear at times a pin drop. You can see those facial expressions of wow, this is real, this is full on.
We're really proud that 89% of the people that hear the Sammy D presentation walk away from a violent situation next time they come up against one. It's really hard to stop yourself when you're that angry, but if you've got a mate there telling you it's not the right thing to do, if you see your mate getting that angry and you start pulling your mate away and say, come on, it's not worth it, let's go, then it's less likely for someone to do something when they've got their peers telling them they don't like what they're doing.
It's been quite a sight to behold in terms of just watching 300 kids glued to Neil, and there they are just transfixed on the message of looking after their friends.
Hearing Sam's story definitely made me realise the importance of life and how someone you love can be gone in the blink of an eye, and how we have the responsibility to look after our mates and all those around us, and that it really is important to take that seriously.
Of course, I'd do anything to have my son back. I'd rather have my son here and not having to do the work that we do. There's not a day that I don't want to get out of bed in the morning and go into work, and everyone that works for the Sammy D Foundation is exactly the same.
I certainly believe that Sam's story and his legacy is one of mateship, and one in which he calls for people to look out for each other and to be a good friend of all.
It's all about looking after your mates. Have your friends for the rest of your life, because I know Sam's friends would do anything to have him back.